Namaste everyone, this is Dr. Pratibha Kays, Head Department of Biotechnology at KLE Societies S, Engineeringappa College, Rajendranagar, Bengaluru. Today I'm before you to introduce one of my students, Mr. Shivakampa Sharma. From second year CZBT, he is presenting his seminar talk on hormones. Now over to Shivakampa.
Good morning to everyone guys. My name is Shivakampa Sharma from second year CZBT, KLE College. And today let's discuss about a topic, hormones and their functions. Now, when we first view the word hormone, what comes to your mind? Everyone thinks different of hormones. And let's know the actual what is hormones in the next slides. The contents included in this seminar are introduction, classification of hormones, synthesis of hormones, important structure of hormones, and the references. Now, what are hormones? Hormones are the chemical messengers that are secreted directly into the blood, which carries them to organs and tissues of the body to exert their function. These are many types and of hormones that act on different aspects of bodily functions and processes. As we are the biotechnology students, we have to be specific about each and everything. While these hormones are specific, they act only on specific cells, on the specific receptors, and the specific functions in our body like development and growth, metabolism of food items, sexual functions and reproductive growth and health, cognitive functions and mood, maintenance of body temperature. These different functions of the body are performed by the different hormones which are released from the different glands in the body. And while we speak about the body, we have to keep in mind that our body is controlled by three types. One is the nervous system, and one is the immune system, and third is the endocrine system. Now let's summarize what is this three types. Nervous system controls the fast movement of the body, like walking, running, heavy breathing, etc. And when it comes to the immune system, it controls the invaders of the body, like foreign particles, bacteria, whatever. It fights against them. Now, the main concept of our seminar, it comes to the endocrine gland. These endocrine glands functions the slow rate of the body. For example, growth of a hormone. Can we see the growth in 2 or 3 days? No. It takes some specific time to visualize the growth of the body. So it's called as endocrine glands. Now let's know the discovery of hormones. The word discovery of hormones was led by the scientist called as Starling. And the first hormone to be discovered is secretin in the year 1902. And while this hormone to get in the society, the first to recognize is this chemical regulations of this hormone. Through knowing these chemical regulations of this hormone, they introduced the word hormone concept in the year 1905. Until today, more than 200 hormones or hormone-like substances have been discovered. To know more information regarding the discovery of the hormone, you could go through the link given below. Now, when we know what are these hormones and what their functions, let's know how is this secreted in the body. The hormones are secreted from the endocrine glands in the body. The glands are ductless, so hormones are secreted directly into the bloodstream rather than by a way of ducts. Some of the major endocrine glands in the human body include pituitary gland, pineal gland, thymus, thyroid, adrenal gland, pancreas, testes, and ovary. Here are the glands. These glands secrete specific hormones which perform specific function in the body. Now, these organs secrete hormone in a microscopic amount, and it takes only a very small amounts to bring about major changes in the body. Now this line, we could take an example of height. Now for a person's height, some of the person's height might take a visualization of 2 to 3 months to have a height visual. So these hormones are secreted in the microscopic amount, so it takes a very huge time to visualize. Now let's know how is this hormone synthesized. In the nucleus, first, when we take in the first the nucleus from the DNA, it is converted into an mRNA, and in the ribosomes, this mRNA is converted into pre-pro hormones. And when this pre in the endoplasmic reticulum, these pre-pro hormones is converted into an pro hormones, and later the pro hormones in the Golgi apparatus is converted into a peptide hormone. When there is a necessary or the brain sends a signal that there is a necessary of this hormone, then through the secretory vesicles, these peptide hormones are released into the blood. Well, let's see the second point, transport. Upon release, travel freely in the blood. Upon signaling from the brain, these peptide hormones are released in the blood. And now let's know what is this function, how it functions, like binding and effects. When a cell needs a specific function to happen, these hormones are released, and on the surface of each cell, there are specific receptors. I'm stressing every time the word specific, because when we are studying about the hormones, we have to be very specific, because all the hormones cannot function the same. All the hormones cannot happens to function the same functions in the human body. So specific hormone functions specific aspects in the human body. Like when the hormones bind to the specific receptor, the cell needs some functioning or any changes. Then after binding to the surface receptor, these changes happens. Now, there are some different glands which secrete different hormones, like hypothalamus secretes dopamine, vasopressin. Like pituitary gland secretes prolactin, oxytocin, vasopressin. Thymus secretes thymocroatin, liver secretes THPO. Like these are the different glands which secrete different hormones. This is the reason why I said specific gland secretes specific hormone. Now, let's know how this hormone functions. When we take a basic example, like menstrual cycle, the brain controls the pituitary gland. The pituitary gland converts the ovary. This is a summary, three-step summary. Now, let's take it in somewhat deeper. The brain releases a hormone called as GnRH. It is also known as gonadotropin-releasing hormone. The GnRH makes the pituitary gland to release a hormone called as FSH. It is called as follicle stimulating hormone. Now, the FSH causes the follicles to grow and make estradiol. Now, what estradiol is also called as E2. Now, before knowing this, our body can't accept anything more or anything less. If there is more, it causes diversification, and if it's more, it causes some defect. So our body should maintain everything and anything should in an equilibrium way. So this estradiol sends a feedback to the brain and pituitary to keep the whole system in control. When the brain and the pituitary senses the increase in the level of E2, this switches off the release of hormones like GnRH or FSH, which stops the process. This is the same way which maintains the body in an equilibrium state. Now, classification of hormones. Based on the chemical nature of hormones, they are classified into three groups. The first one, amino acid derivatives, protein and peptide hormones, steroid hormones. Let's know about this classification depth. First, what are these amino acid derivatives? These are low molecular weight compounds containing amino group and are derived from a single amino acid. Example, epinephrine and thyroxine. Let's know what is this epinephrine and thyroxine. What is epinephrine? Epinephrine is also called as fight hormone. Why do we call it as a fight hormone? There is a reason why do we call it as a fight hormone. Let's know about it. The chemical structure of this epinephrine is C9H13O3N. Epinephrine, more commonly known as adrenaline, is a hormone secreted by the medulla of the adrenal gland. Strong emotions such as fear or anger causes epinephrine to be released into the bloodstreams, which causes an increase in the heart rate, muscle strength, blood pressure, and sugar metabolism. This reaction is also known as fight response. This is the reason why I said it's called as a fight hormone. Prepares the body for strenuous activity. It means if an emergency that happens that is needed by the body, then this hormone is been released. Epinephrine is found in small amounts in the body and is essential for maintaining cardiovascular hemostasis because of its ability to divert blood into different tissues under stress. What is this hemostasis? It means maintenance of human body temperature in an equilibrium. The maintenance of equilibrium body temperature is known as hemostasis. For further information regarding this epinephrine, you could follow the below link. What are these functions of epinephrine? It increases BMR, basal metabolic rate. It increases the blood pressure. As we all know that when there is a strong emotion such as fear or anger, this epinephrine is released into the bloodstream. It causes the increase in the blood pressure. And it also acts on the adipose tissue and increases fatty acid oxidation. Now we have known about this epinephrine. What is this epinephrine and its functions? Now let's know the second type, thyroid hormone. Thyroid is the largest endocrine gland in the human body. The thyroid gland produces three types of hormones known as triiodothyronine, also known as T3. Tetraiodothyronine, also known as thyroxine or T4. And the third one is calcitosin. I think the structures of T3 and T4 are quite visible. There is a simple change in an iodine content in T3 and T4. Now, you can ask, what are these three proteins like distributed? I said, every hormone is a specific. So, to distribute these hormones released from this gland needs a specific proteins to transport it through a bloodstream to a specific cell. So these are the three distributor proteins which help the thyroid release hormones to distribute to the specific cell, like albumin and thyroxine binding globulin and transthyretin. These are the three protein distributor proteins which distributes this hormone. Now let's know the functions of the thyroid hormone. It lowers blood cholesterol level. It has role in growth and development. It stimulates heart contraction. Let's have a note here. The insufficient secretion of thyroxine is called as hypothyroidism. Hypothyroidism in adults is called as maxedema. Increased activity of thyroid hormones occurs in exothalamic goiter. It is also called as hyperthyroidism. As I have said that our body needs anything in an equilibrium. If there is an excess content, it's called as diversification or any problem to it. And if it's low, it also causes a problem. So you have to maintain everything in an equilibrium. The enlargement of thyroid gland is known as goiter. Now, the second type of classification is protein and peptide hormones. What are these protein and peptide hormones? Hormones whose molecules are peptides or proteins respectively are called as peptide hormones. The latter have longer amino acid chain lengths than the former. Then the rest, these have the longer amino acid chains. Example, insulin, glucagon, oxytocin, vasopressin, or etc. What are the functions of this peptide hormone? Peptide hormones are secreted and the function is an endocrine manner to regulate many physiological functions, including growth, appetite, and energy metabolism, cardiac functions, stress, and reproductive psychology. Many signal via GPCRs. What is a GPCRs? G protein coupled receptors. These protein peptide hormones is signaled via GPCRs. G protein coupled receptors. I request everyone to note down this one. And what is this insulin? As we have said that we are biotechnology students, we have to be specific in each thing. When someone asks, where is this insulin secreted? We can't just say it is secreted in the pancreas. We have to be specific. It is a peptide hormone which is secreted in the beta cells of islets of Langerhans in the pancreas with a molecular weight of 5,734 daltons. As we know that the difference between polypeptide hormone and the protein, well, this polypeptide hormones which has the molecular weight less than 10,000 daltons is considered as peptide hormones. It consists of two polypeptide chains linked together by two disulfide bonds. These have two chains. The chain one has 21 amino acids. The chain two has 30 amino acids. Who discovered this insulin? The person called as Banting in the year 1922 isolated insulin for the first time. Now let's know how it is being secreted. It is secreted as an inactive precursor pre-proinsulin, which is later converted into a proinsulin by the proteolytic cleavage and is stored in secretory vesicles in pancreatic cells. What is this function of this insulin? When we study about this insulin, we have to know the function of it. Insulin elevated blood glucose level triggers the release of proinsulin and is converted into an active insulin. Now, here's the flow chart. Pre-proinsulin is first converted into proinsulin, and later it's converted into insulin, and then it is being streamed through the blood vessels. What is this effects of insulin? Inhibits glucogenesis. Insulin acts as an anabolic hormone for protein synthesis. Insulin also influences the metabolism of potassium and phosphate. Here is the basic structure of insulin. In the chain A, it consists of 21 amino acids. Chain B consists of 30 amino acids. Now, the chain A and chain B is connected through the disulfide bond. The seventh amino acids of the A chain is connected to the seventh amino acids of the B chain. And the second disulfide bond is connected 20th base amino acids of the A chain is connected to the 19th amino acids of the B chain. Now, here is an example. This is the pancreas, and the smaller one is the islet, and the larger one is the beta cells. There is a part, not everything is a beta cells, there is a part called a beta cells. Here is a normal insulin which secretes insulin. Elevated glucose level signals the brain to the pancreas to release insulin into the blood. And then insulin binds to the cell and controls the glucose level. And when there is a, we know that diabetes, type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes. Here is the difference between the type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes. In the type 1 diabetes, destruction of beta cells takes place, which can't synthesize the insulin. And in the type 2 diabetes, reduced insulin production causes, which cannot regulate the blood glucose level. And what is this glucagon? Glucagon, hypergalemic factor, is also known as hypergalemic factor. It is a linear polypeptide containing 29 amino acids with molecular weight 3,484 daltons. It is secreted by the alpha cells of islets of Langerhans in pancreas. It is secreted in response of low blood glucose. This is directly inversely proportional to the insulin. If there is an increased level in the blood, if there is an increased level in the glucose in the blood, there is a release of insulin. If there is low concentration of glucose in the blood, there is a release of glucagon. There is a difference in the, there is a difference called A alpha cells and beta cells. Beta cells synthesizes insulin, alpha cells synthesize glucagon. What is this function? It increases K plus release from liver. It has catabolic effect on proteins. In adipose tissue, it increases breakdown of lipids. Breakdown of lipids is also called as lipolysis. Now, we shall know what is this oxytocin. Oxytocin is a hormone secreted by the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland. The main thing while studying about this hormone, we have to know from where it is secreted and what is its function. It is secreted in the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland. The structure of it, it might be a P-shaped structure at the base of the brain. It's sometimes known as cuddle hormone or the love hormone. Because why it is called as this different type of hormone? Because it is released when people bond socially. How is this structure? It is a cyclic nanopeptide made of 9 amino acids with a molecular weight of 1000 daltons. Let's know oxytocin in specific. Boiling point of this oxytocin is 1533 Celsius. Formula of this oxytocin, C43H66N12O12S2. Source, where it is secreted? It is secreted in the pituitary glands. Elimination half-life, 1 to 6 minutes. Now, vasopressin. What is this vasopressin called as? Anti-diuretic hormone, ADH. It is an nanopeptide synthesized in the hypothalamus. It has known to play essential role in the control of body's osmotic balance, body's pressure regulation, sodium hemostasis, and kidney functioning. Vasopressin decreases water excretion by the kidney by increasing the water reabsorption in the collecting ducts. Hence, it has other name of anti-diuretic hormone. We have to know why it is called with an anti-diuretic hormone. Because it decreases water excretion by the kidney by the reabsorption in the collecting ducts. It's very important. Let's know the formula of this vasopressin. C46, H65, N15, O12, S2. What is this molecular weight? Molecular mass 1084.24 grams per mole. Excretion, urine. There are some specific receptors. While we have been studying in the thyroid hormone, there were three receptors, three protein distributors, which distributes them. In the same way, vasopressin has these receptors like V1A, V1B, V2, OXTR. These are the receptors which distributes this vasopressin. Alternative name, anti-dietetic hormone, arginine, vasopressin, AVP. Next, the third type of classification comes the steroid hormones. What are the steroid hormones? A steroid that acts as a hormone that are fat-soluble compounds derived from cholesterol. Steroid hormones can be grouped into two classes. The first is the corticosteroids. What is meant by corticosteroids? Typically made in the adrenal cortex, hence known as cortico. And sex steroids, typically made in the gonads or placenta. So these are known as sex hormones, sex steroids, or cortico because it is typically made in the adrenal cortex. You have to know why it is named and the type of this steroid hormones, androgens. What are these androgens? These are a group of hormones that play a role in male triads and reproductive activity, present in both males as well as females. The principal androgens are testosterone and androstenedione. Androgens may be called male hormones, but don't let the name fool you. After knowing it is called as a male hormone, you might think that it is only secreted in the males. No, it is secreted in both males as well as females. What is this now? Testosterone. Let's come close up. Testosterone. It is a primary sex hormone and anabolic steroid in males. In male humans, testosterone plays a key role in development of male reproductive tissue such as testes and prostate, as well as promoting secondary sexual characteristics such as increased muscles and bone mass and growth of body hair. We all know that what are the secondary sexual characteristics. For in males, it might be the deeper voice and growth of beard, etc. Now, the formula of this testosterone, C19H28O2, molecular mass 288.42 grams per mole. Metabolism, where it has been metabolized? In the liver. Biological half-life, 2 to 4 hours. Estrogens, what are these estrogens? These are the derivatives of C18 hydrocarbons. It's known as estrone. They are produced by the graafian follicles in the ovary. Please note down where these hormones are being produced. Progesterone is the primary female sex hormone. It is responsible for the development and regulation of the female reproductive system and secondary sexual characters. In the males, the secondary sexual characters have been produced by the testosterone. In females, it is produced by the estrogens. There are three major endogenous estrogens in the females that have estrogenic hormonal activity. What are the three? Estrone, estradiol, estrol. Biological target, where this triggers? Estrogen receptors, ERA. ER, it's known as A, it's alpha. ERB, it's beta. MERS, example, GPR, other. Note, estrogen is involved in repairing and thickening the uterus lining. Progesterone maintains the uterine lining. I hope you should know the difference between this progesterone and progesterone. Important structures. I hope you could copy these structures. Cholesterol, corticosterone, aldosterone, progesterone, beta estradiol, testosterone. These structures might be important for the exams. And adrenocortical hormone. The adrenal gland has two distinct parts, namely outer cortex and the inner medulla. These two different parts secrete different type of hormones. Both secrete different types of hormones, which differ chemically as well as physiology. On stimulation of adrenal cortex by adrenocorticotropic hormone, it is also known as ACTH. From the pituitary. It is secreted from the pituitary. The cells of adrenal cortex secretes mineralocorticoids as well as glucocorticoids. let's know what are these mineralocorticoids as well as glucocorticoids. Mineralocorticoids in the class of corticosteroids, which in turn are a class of steroid hormones. Mineralocorticoids are produced in the adrenal cortex and influence salt and water balance. The primary mineralocorticoid is aldosterone. What is the function of mineralocorticoid? It maintains the salt content as well as the water balance in the body. If there is a low water balance, if there is a low water content in the body, it might cause kidney stones, etc. Now, what is this glucocorticoids? Glucocorticoid drugs are man-made versions of glucocorticoids, steroids that occur naturally in the body. They have many functions. One is to interrupt inflammation by moving into cells and suppressing the proteins that go on to promote inflammation. They also help our body respond to stress and regulate how your body uses fat and sugar. Because glucocorticoids have so many functions, man-made or synthetic glucocorts have been developed to help treat many different conditions. When we know how to synthesize a hormone, we could synthesize it artificially and make use of it. Now the same happened in the glucocorticoids. We synthesize it artificially and we are having the benefits of it. Example of these glucocorticoid drugs includes beclomethasone and cortisone and dexamethasone, hydrocortisone and betamethasone. These are some of the examples of these glucocorticoid drugs. And how these drugs help the humankind to treat, in example like autoimmune disorders, allergies and asthma and cancer. What is autoimmune disorders? Autoimmune disorders can cause extensive damage from inflammation when the body mistakenly attacks itself. Our immune system attacks our own cells. This condition is called as autoimmune system. Like for example, ulcerative colitis is an example of this autoimmune system. Now there are other two examples, you can note them. Allergies and asthma. How could these glucocorticoids disease, allergies and asthma, in the disease called as itching and lightheadedness? These two and these three and other examples are there, which we could treat by taking these glucocorticoid drugs. And cancer, how could these glucocorticoid drugs treat the cancer? Glucocorticoids can be used in cancer therapy to reduce some of the side effects of chemotherapy. As now, chemotherapy is the only technique to treat cancer. There are some other side effects in the chemotherapy. So using these glucocorticoids, we could reduce the side effects. They may be also used to kill some cancer cells in some cancers, like including acute lymphoblastic leukemia, chronic lymphoblastic leukemia. For more information regarding this glucocorticoids function, you could follow this link. I have some questions for your friends. How do you balance your hormones? What is the purpose of hormones? Which is the most powerful hormone? What is the happy hormone? Which is the most important hormone in the body? I have given the answer for the first question. Like these are the, through following these, you could balance your hormones. Guys, I have a video to show you all, but it's not opening through phone. Start a day with a positive thought and a great heart. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, Shivapampa. Thank you, Mr. Shivapampa, for your wonderful presentation on hormones. Okay, whatever technical issues happen, don't worry.
Ma'am, if you don't mind, can I show the video,
yeah,
ma'am?
Yeah, please.
It's taking some time. It's a good video. It's a general video of animated. Guys, 1 second, please.
Yeah, carry on. Thank you once again, Mr. Shivapampa. Interaction session we will do in our regular classes. I thank all the students for your valuable time and quality of time on this Sunday for this special seminar class. Thank you, everyone. And whatever this today's feedback, you'll receive in regular class. Okay? Thank you.